What's poppin', Barons?
On today's episode, we'll continue BCC TV's celebration of Women's History Month.
Dive into another one of Kai's hot takes.
And sip some tea with Abby Kay. I'm Ben Moran.
And I'm Amelia Stanley.
And you're watching BCC TV.
Yo, Ben, what's going on in the news this week?
Another round of Democratic primaries were held this week, with former Vice President Joe Biden taking a commanding lead. A debate between the former VP and Senator Bernie Sanders is scheduled to take place this Sunday.
The number of confirmed cases of the coronavirus in the U.S. has risen to above 1,000 and at least 28 deaths in the U.S. It's important to always wash your hands, and if you aren't feeling 100%, stay home. We don't want to risk anything.
In BCC News, the annual MSP retreat was held last Saturday at Quince Orchard High School. Let's see how it went.
Thanks, Louison. That looks so lit.
It might be lit, but is it as lit as what the best specialty anchor BCC TV has to offer?
Let's pass it off to
Jay. No. You got it all wrong.
Okay, well, let's pass it off to Kai.
No, sis, get these trash men anchors out of here. We passing it to Abigail. Let's learn about some women's history.
For Women's History Month, I wanted to make a list of maybe 4 or 5 women who really did incredible things throughout history. But because I'm an idiot who doesn't know when to stop, I made a list of 22. I only have 2 minutes, so we have to get started really fast. Hatshepsut, one of the first female Egyptian pharaohs who led a series of trading campaigns and building projects that led her kingdom to prosperity. Sappho, a gay icon and one of the most iconic female poets in all of human history, even earning the praise of later scholars like Plato, which is really saying something because he hated women. On the revolutionary side of things, there are Trung Trac and Trung Nhi, sisters who fought against the conquering of Vietnam and China, and Boudica, an Irish Celtic leader who battled against Roman tyranny over Britain. There's Agnodice, who disguised herself as a man in order to study medicine and help women during childbirth. Murasaki Shikibu, the author of The Tale of Genji, the first novel ever written. Empress Matilda, who after being denied her rightful throne, established her own kingdom and forced the current king to cede his throne to her children following his death.
Sor Juana Inés de la Cruz,
a nun, scholar, writer, and philosopher in 17th century Mexico. Ching Shi, a prostitute turned pirate, sometimes called the Terror of South China, Mary Shelley, the writer of Frankenstein, and credited with the invention of the science fiction genre, Lozin, an Apache warrior, quoted as being strong as a man, braver than most, and cunning in strategy. Ida B. Tarbell, a 19th century reformer who exposed Rockefeller oil as the unethical monopoly that it was. Madam C.J. Walker, she became one of the first female self-made entrepreneurs by designing products specifically targeted for African-American hair. Lily Elbe, one of the first people to undergo male-to-female gender reassignment surgery. Josephine Baker, a French-American dancer turned spy for the Allies. Rachel Carson, a woman who openly studied and exposed the harm that pesticides can do to the environment. Christine Jorgensen, a trans woman who publicly underwent sex reassignment surgery and advocated for the rights of others to do so. Rita Moreno, the only Latina to win an EGOT, Emmy, Grammy, Oscar, and Tony. Marsha P. Johnson, allegedly the first person to throw a brick at Stonewall and a fantastic trans woman activist. Sunithna Krishnan, the co-founder of Prajwala, an organization designed to help sex trafficking victims reintegrate into society. And finally, Nadezhda Tolokonikova, a performance artist and songwriter who continues to protest against Vladimir Putin's totalitarian regime, even after facing the horrors of Russian imprisonment for 2 straight years. This is only scratching the surface of all the amazing female figures throughout history, and I highly recommend that you do your own research and seek them out. Maybe check out Ms. Cameron's Board of Women for some inspiration. But anyway, women are awesome. Back to you, Ben and Amelia.
Thanks, Abigail.
See, Amelia? She is the best.
I guess you've changed my mind.
What's up, Barons? Today I'm here with possibly my most hot topic yet. Chick-fil-A is overrated. People be coming out here saying Chick-fil-A the best restaurant. Chick-fil-A slaps. First of all, Chick-fil-A don't fill you up. I'm not saying the food's not good, but it doesn't fill you up. Second of all, they're not keeping in mind the nut allergen people.
You saying Chick-fil-A is overrated? That's wrong.
Bro, Popeye's sides, pound for pound, are better. The rice. They got dirty rice. Chick-fil-A don't care about us like that.
The one time I went there's hair in my fries.
Swear, don't we talk about the customer service so good? They got hair in my girl fries.
It's all gross. It's overrated. Why does everybody like it? It's like a regular chicken sandwich.
Chick-fil-A don't care about that.
Chick-fil-A is good. It's satisfying. You get the chicken sandwich, the fries, and the lemonade. That's all you need.
So what's your problem with the sandwiches?
I don't know. Too much bread.
I'm vegan.
All right. So now we have a vegan perspective. What are the options at Chick-fil-A for you? Because I know that salad trash.
Nothing.
All right, so what's your opinion?
Chick-fil-A is the best.
It's the best.
Yeah, it's the best fast food restaurant.
It slaps. As long as it gets the job done.
Gets the job done? It don't even be how many chicken sandwiches you got to eat to get full?
At least two.
All right, then.
That's
at least
waste
two.
Of money. It's like eating a home-cooked meal. It's just so good.
A home-cooked meal. I'm not saying Chick-fil-A is bad, but the y'all be acting like God himself dipped his hands in the batter and just lathered it on the chicken.
Chick-fil-A is carried by the sauce.
Simple. Chick-fil-A is carried by the sauce.
Yeah, but she's my Chick-fil-A.
You can't say our milkshakes aren't better than Popeye's.
Popeye's
doesn't even have any milkshake.
Relax.
I've had Chick-fil-A and the Popeye's chicken sandwich, and I was unimpressed with Popeye's.
All Chick-fil-A sells is chicken.
It's a chicken restaurant.
Okay, so Popeye's.
Chick-fil-A tries to pull this tactic of making a cool shape for their fries, little waffle fries. If you put them in regular McDonald's and Wendy's shape, they're average.
So
you know when you take that Popeye skin off, you peel that joint, you put it in your mouth for that joint.
Just admit that Popeye's.
And for real, the lunchroom chicken patty from elementary school?
Yo, that's bad.
Low key, go get that lunchroom food. Go get that chocolate milk. You know chocolate milk George. Chocolate milk just George.
Back to you, Ben and Amelia.
Thanks, Kai. Great stuff, dog.
You know, I like Kai, but he's a little too crazy for me. Let's relax a little bit and have some tea with Abby K.
Okay, I'm Abigail Kessel and this is Tea Time with Abby. Today I'm here with three different women to talk about their invisible disabilities and how it's affected them. Do you guys mind mentioning what your disability is?
Yeah. I'm Ruby, and my disability is called panhyperpituitarism. It's an endocrine disorder. It basically means that I get sick a lot.
I'm Maria, and I was born with a rare congenital heart disease.
I'm Catriona Myman, everyone calls me Katie, and I have something called dysautonomia. So basically, the part of my nervous system that controls the automatic functions of my body, like my heart beating, breathing, and digesting food, is broken, so I have a hard time just being alive. Yeah.
Wow, that is rough. Do you guys ever feel defined by your disability?
I know personally I do not like to define myself by my disability. It is just a part of me.
I know, I feel like the world wants me to say that I'm not defined by my disability and that I'm more than just my disability. And that's definitely true, but I feel like there's more to it than just that. Every day is something I truly struggle with. I have to fight to just be alive. But it's also made me stronger, and it's made me who I am today. So I would say my disability, yes, it does define me, but that's not something I'm ashamed of.
Do you guys feel like you've been treated differently by everyday people and by people that you know well because of your disability?
One time I was on the elevator because I have an elevator key. And so these guys who had broken legs, they were asking me where my crutches were. You don't know what's going on inside of me, and you can't assume that I'm perfectly normal because you can't see it on the outside.
After two of my surgeries, I was in a wheelchair, and that made me have a visible disability. Because when I asked for help, there was an immediate response of, yes, I will help you. But when you ask for help when you can't see your disability, you get questioned or you get untrustworthy, like, stares.
I experienced the same thing. I just got out of my wheelchair that I was in for 3.5 years. And people used to be so nice. And I remember I was in my wheelchair and everyone would hold the door for me. As soon as I got out of it, one of the first things that happened is someone slammed the door right in my face.
What do you wish people knew about you?
Everyone is going through a hard time that you can't see. It's like a lot of times, a lot of things I'm doing, I can appear lazy, like I just don't want to do things, but it's really because I physically can't.
I think we need to focus on education, because a lot of even students with invisible disabilities are not aware of their rights. Also, education would help with other students developing empathy.
Well, thank you guys so much.
Back to you, Ben and Amelia.
Thanks, Abby.
Let's pass it off to Aiden Rose for sports.
What's goody, Barons? Last week, BCC Wrestling had 4 guys in the state semifinals. Drew, at 152, sadly couldn't continue after the match due to injury and ended up taking 6th place. Gio Martinez, at 145, lost a close battle against the state champ 2-4. Gio would come all the way back and take 3rd. Drew and Gio are now 2-time state placers.
Christian Simpson at 106 and Ike Gruenthal at 113 both made it to the finals, with Ike Gruenthal coming out as our 5th state champ in his school history. That's all for winter sports this season. Back to you,
Ben and Amelia.
Thanks, Aiden Rose.
And that's all for this week, Barons.
Check back in next Friday for more news, updates, and humor. Keep the standards high.
And stay classy, BCC.
I'm Amelia Stanley.
And I'm Ben Moran.
And we're signing off.
Women are cool. Girls are hot. Girls.